I got this really cute email in my inbox last night, and if you don't mind me reading it to you real quick, I kind of need your guys' help. I would love to have you help me answer this email. So there's actually this dad that wrote to me, and I thought it was really cute because he has a daughter that watches my videos. So it's a it's a small email. I'm gonna read it to you guys real quick. The dad's name's Charlie, and it says, "Hi Guitar Goddess, my daughter is a massive fan. I'm trying to keep her motivated to continue learning guitar. She's only 11. I know you're probably really busy, so no worries if you can't, but if you could make a really short video just encouraging her to keep up the practice and the learning of new techniques and songs, that would be brilliant. Best wishes from New Zealand." So I wrote back to him and I asked for his daughter's name, and he said that her name is Christina, and that she's been playing guitar and ukulele for a few years and loves it, but of course, like most 11-year-olds, gets distracted with other stuff. And if dad tells her to keep practicing, she won't listen, but if you do, dot, 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 dot. And that just really touched my heart because my dad has always been so supportive of me playing guitar and practicing, and he continues to be. So Christina, if you're watching this video, I want to share some advice with you, and also anybody here that is from the GG community or anybody that has stumbled across this video, if you have any advice for Christina, please leave it down below in the comments section. Anything that has helped you stay motivated, helped you with your practicing sessions, and why you're glad that you stuck with it, please, please leave that down below. And anyone that is stumbling across this video that might also be in Christina's situation, I hope that this video helps you too. As far as advice from me, so Christina, the first thing that I want to tell you is that if you love playing the guitar, obviously it sounds like you do, that's what your dad said, you love it, you enjoy it. If it's something that you want to continue to pursue, you have to do it for you. You can't do it because your dad wants you to do it. You have to do it because it makes you excited. So remember why you started. Why did you pick up the guitar? Remember what that was that sparked your interest, because going back to that initial moment for you, that initial moment of inspiration, is going to help reignite that flame, remembering the why. And then the next thing that I would do is find new songs, play new songs. You start to get in a rut if you play the same things over and over again. Find new songs that you love, because if they're songs that you love, they're gonna motivate you to practice. And something else that I would do, Christina, is set a timer every single day. I know you have at least 15 minutes in your day to fit some practice session in. I don't know if dad allows you to have a phone at 11, but if he does, or if you have a timer, you can borrow dad's phone, set a timer for 15 minutes and practice for at least just that. But you'll find that sometimes you're gonna want to go past that 15 minutes, and 15 minutes might turn into 20 minutes, 30 minutes, a full hour, sometimes 2 hours. That's what happens with me. And just setting aside that time of day ensures that you're gonna at least get some kind of practice in, even if it was maybe just 15 minutes. But I know it can be hard sometimes between school and maybe other activities that you have, but if guitar and ukulele are something that you really love and you wanna continue to do, you definitely just need to make time for it. And also, Christina, definitely make sure that you are setting goals for yourself. If your school has a talent show, you should definitely think about signing up for it. I think that would be such a fun thing to do. If there's a song that you feel like you would love to perform, I would definitely 100% go for it. And the thing is, why I'm making this video, not just for you, Christina, but for anybody else out there that is in this situation, is that when I started guitar at 14, going on 15 years old, I did not foresee what this instrument was gonna do for my life. And I'm just gonna set you guys down right here on my desk. I would not be here talking to you in this video had I not continued to practice. I wouldn't have a YouTube channel teaching guitar. I would not have gone to GitCon this year. I wouldn't have gone to NAMM. I would not have had the opportunity to perform at VidCon over the summer. So many opportunities came into my life because of playing guitar. I've hit many plateaus in my guitar playing where I just felt like I didn't know where to go. And I don't know if you've actually caught on to my electric guitar series or maybe even some of my finger picking stuff, but my guitar journey isn't over. With you at the same time, I am still learning how to play the guitar, but in different ways. I'm learning how to play lead on the electric and Just last night, actually, I was practicing my finger picking on the acoustic guitar and working on my percussive style as well, because it's something completely new and something that I don't have a lot of experience with. I'm not done learning. So if you need some more encouragement, definitely check out those videos. I will link them down below in the description box. You can check them out and you see me just in real time learning how to play different styles on the guitar, and I mess up right in front of you guys, and I think that's important for you guys to see. I know a lot of you guys look up to me and in my videos, but I want you to see that I'm also still in the process of learning as well. And so hopefully you found this video encouraging and motivating, and I urge you, Christina, to read the comments with your dad, and I'm sure you're going to see a lot of love, support, and encouragement down below. I look forward to hearing from you soon, and I love you. Bye!